Welcome, everybody. Welcome, David. Good to see you all on the stream. My name is Maniac. I'll be your host for this evening, where we are going to be broadcasting Quantum Break on the Xbox One. Before we get started, a couple of things really quick. I don't know how well this is going to run, because this game is being run entirely on a backup drive that I have plugged into my Xbox One. As such, I don't know if there's I've noticed occasional stutters and things like that. If that continues to happen, there's not much I can do about it. Secondly, can everybody hear me? Just leave a comment if you can hear me. Can you guys hear me over there? Yes, I did start the game. That was not my bad. What basically happened was is that this game doesn't have a menu system when you turn the game on. When you turn the game on for the first time, it immediately asks you what difficulty you want to play, and then you just push A and the game starts. And there's no way to stop or pause or reset through the opening cutscene. It's just not possible. And so because of that, I basically had to start the stream as soon as I could first pop up the original, you know, this is literally the first second of the game that I was able to actually, this is the first second of the game that I was able to actually hit the pause button so I could start the stream. I wasn't intending to just start the stream, but unfortunately that seems to have been what happened. Really, you didn't miss much. It was just basically a small interview between the main character and a woman who we don't know in the Monarch Corporation building. It might be better that you guys don't know, because for all I know, I could get a copyright claim for simply when I post up for this section, so...
You'd been away for 6 years.
Paul and I had kept in touch, but, well, not so much.
How did it make you feel?
I was just happy to see Paul.
Controls are very similar to Alan Wake, actually, right now. Wow. Performance is good.
Paul told me to meet him at the physics building.
This kind of reminds me of, like,
I guess I should go find Paul.
Yale or Cambridge or something like that. Yeah, this is running entirely on my, Oh, there it is. Okay. Yeah, this is running entirely on my hard drive right now. Let me rephrase this. It's running on my backup hard drive right now. I couldn't fit it on the primary.
I doubt he's out here. I better head into the campus.
I'm glad you saw my unboxing. Oh, who's this guy?
Good morning.
Yeah.
Recognize him. What's he doing, just kind of standing around?
Whatever you want. I don't have the time.
Okay. Yeah, I'm noticing a V-Sync problem. That could be because I'm streaming it. Sorry. Yeah, I'm noticing a bit of a V-Sync problem. That could be because I'm streaming the game. That could be because the game is just, yeah. I feel like I should set this a little darker. Hold on. Okay, that looks a little bit better. Can I talk to him?
Rough night, huh?
It's just whatever's doesn't even matter anymore. Yeah.
Looks like he's had fun. But like I said, this kind of reminds me of, like, Yale. Oh, it wasn't... The discs would not break when you put them in the steelbook. Here, I'll show you. This is the steelbook for Batman Arkham Knight. It's the thing is, if you ever had to deal with a steelbook, putting a disc in a steelbook in this protected spot is not going to affect the steelbook itself or the disc. The disc will be fine in here, actually, and it's actually going to be pretty... It's going to be pretty tough. It's the disc will be safe inside the steelbook, and the steelbook is not exactly going to go anywhere. The hard part is getting the disc out. This plastic retention rod right here is a really tough little bastard, basically. And you usually got to pull really hard on those discs once they're in the case to get them out of the case. Now, after a lot of use, basically, of putting the disc in and pulling the disc out, they get worn down and they become a little easier to manipulate. But especially given the fact that this is metal, you know, this is metal, it's very difficult to push down on that retention disc. Like, if it's something like this, this is just regular Halo 5 disc packaging. You know, this is a plastic retention rod on a plastic backing. It's very easy simply just to pop the disc out of this because it's malleable. This plastic is very easy to manipulate with your hands. It's soft. But this steelbook is steel. It's solid. And so if you... It usually takes a lot of force to pull the disc out once it's in the steelbook. And the force it would take to pull the disc out can break the disc.
Paul. Jack. I just got to the campus. Where are you?
God, it's good to hear your voice. When you hit the courtyard, look right, you'll see this fancy modern physics building with the lights on. I'll meet you inside there. I am so looking forward to this, man.
You still haven't told me what this is.
I know. See you soon.
Why 4 a.m.? Why not wait till morning? Paul had always been a showman.
Hey, you, take action now. Yeah, there's something big happening here. Okay. Oh, there's something here, too. Let me go check this out.
That's vaguely ominous.
You want to go bother some protesters? Yeah, this kind of has like a bit of a Harvard kind of feel to it. Let's see what's on here. Guest seminar. The Henry Kim Theater. Okay, not what I thought it would be about. Graphics looks pretty good. Performance is not the greatest, but it's decent. Again, some of this performance could be dependent upon my external drive.
Some protest.
Leave drunks where they be. Just let them sleep it off. That's my motto. Your copy of Halo Wars was in a steelbook. Mine... that wasn't a steelbook, I don't think. If granted, the United States version of Halo Wars wasn't in a steelbook. It was in a tin.
Hey, do you know where the physics building is?
You mean the big-ass metallic turtle behind me? Hard to miss, man.
Thanks.
Oh my god, this is me and my girlfriend right here. I didn't know I was in this game.
Babe, can we go home yet?
Stop Monarch problems. Notice, this is a non-alcoholic event. I wonder if that email works for Amy Ferrero. Yeah, the tins weren't affected because they simply just put the discs in like a decent enough disc sleeve. All right, there's not really much going on here. I know I've been looking at everything, but this game has collectibles and stuff, and I kind of want to get them. Please go around that way.
Hey, it's Bobby Radford here on the tail end of the night shift. How you doing, Riverport? Burning the midnight oil? Just waking up? you getting ready for bed. Or maybe you're asleep. I wouldn't blame you. Not a lot going down in downtown tonight. Now, unless you're at the Riverport University campus, where the protest against Monarch Solutions is still going on. You see, Monarch wants to knock down the old campus library and put up a brand new building. The protesters are saying that building's a part of our heritage, and we don't need Monarch gobbling up yet another bit of Riverport. Personally, I'm with the activists on this one. I'm sure Monarch's new building will be big and shiny, but well, come on, who gives a shit?
I haven't read the negative reviews. I'm being asked about the negative reviews of this game. I have a severe issue with organizations that consider themselves to be mainstream game reviewers. If you ask me, I think that this kind of really started taking off when guys like Yahtzee, who write for The Escapist, you know, became famous overnight simply for, you know, pointing out flaws in pretty bad games. It kind of became a point where everybody started looking for flaws, in some cases in games where the flaws that they pointed out were not, were, I, at least in my opinion, I don't think to be genuine flaws. Okay, back to what I was saying. I don't think that...
Protests seem like a lost cause. Maybe sympathize with the students.
Still looking for more narrative objects, but I don't see any really. I really don't pay the I really haven't paid the what do you call it, any mind. And can I be honest with you? And I know this will probably get me a lot of hate when this is eventually published up on YouTube, but I don't even really pay attention to Yahtzee anymore. I think his quality has gone downhill in the last couple of years, especially. It became very noticeable to me by the time he was reviewing Dead Space 3, for example, that he wasn't, you know, this is a guy like Yahtzee. This is a guy who used to actually be able to point out legitimate flaws in games that we thought were good. And then he became a guy that was able to really just point out the essence as to why a flawed game was so flawed. But sometime around, I don't know, maybe it was Dead Space 3's release, or maybe it was around that time or something, he really just stopped trying. He basically turned his reviews from, oh, this was a flaw, or this was a flaw, to, oh, this just isn't my, you know, this just isn't up to snuff anymore. And he started sounding like those kind of people that I hate, like the people that run the Academy for, you know, for of motion pictures or something. The, you know, a bunch of just, you know, snobbish a-holes that wouldn't know a good product if it bit them on the ass, and only are basically attacking something because they feel like if they attack something that's good, it will get them notoriety, or it'll get them credit, or it'll get them something. That's what it came off to me. That's what this whole attack on Quantum Break, you know, by several of the reviewers in the quote-unquote mainstream. Now, I didn't get a review copy of Quantum Break. I asked. I didn't get one. And so I could not, and I haven't, and I probably won't publish a review of this game because this is literally the first time I'm actually playing it right now. So take for that what you will. Library Liberation Party, very nice, LLP.
If you're with that fraternity, you've done enough damage. We're being shut down.
Hey, I come in peace. I'm just meeting a friend nearby.
At 4 a.m.?
Yeah, tell me about it.
Well, we're spreading awareness about Monarch Solutions, so if you want to know how badly they're giving us the shaft, then you can just ask me.
All right, what's going on here?
Okay. How would you feel if you knew a corporate monopoly was taking a massive dump all over your personal history?
That's quite an opener.
Good. Because that beautiful library over there is over 100 years old. It's part of the city's heritage. And Monarch Solutions plans to tear it down tomorrow. Do you want to know why? We've got a chart with all the details.
Should I keep talking to her? Should I look at the chart? Can I talk? Well.
Go ahead, check out the chart.
Is this the chart? Yep, okay, here it is.
Tearing down the library to build another research facility. And for what?
I bet you're going to tell me.
To push their corporate agenda. I mean, look at those numbers. They're slowly taking over the city and everybody's completely blind to it.
It doesn't look good. Hey, I gotta meet my friend, but you keep fighting this, okay?
All right. Enjoy your booty call.
Not exactly.
Okay, I heard that this is an Easter egg, and I want to check it out really quick.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean. He's been gone for 5 years. Dark matter and dark energy constitute over 95% of our universe. We're just a speck of light floating in an endless ocean of darkness. Every story finds its writer. He smiles a wicked smile. He lies in the blood on his face, eyes staring. All of us have two faces, the one we wear for all to see, and the face that lies beneath in the dark.
Xbox, record that. Oh, I can't record that. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I think that is confirmation that Alan Wake 2 is coming. That sure looked like it. I mean, I heard that was an Easter egg. That is a blatant Easter egg. And I even knew that particular Easter egg was coming because it was, you know, that's... You saw that, didn't you, David? I mean, I don't know if you've played Alan Wake yet, but... I think this means Alan Wake 2. I mean, look at that. You saw that. I can't record it. I can't play it back, but... Was that not Alan Wake 2? You could just see me fanboy squeeing. I actually muted the mic so you couldn't hear me while it was going on because I wanted you to hear it. Oh my god. Fanboy squee. That's got to mean Alan Wake 2 is confirmed. I'm sorry, but that's got to be an Alan Wake 2. If people have been pulling everything, every piece of information from Valve's website, every minor code update or something. But that's... But it, okay. Return was trademarked. Okay? I'm going to kind of fast forward a little bit. We're going to talk about Alan Wake for just a second here. But, you know, you guys don't come to me because I just play it and go, You guys come to me because you want me to talk about what my experiences were and what I know about the game industry. And this is something that I can comment on, okay? First off, that was clearly the actor who played Alan Wake, and that was clearly Sam Lake. Sam Lake confirmed that that was him already, so we know that. They confirmed that picture, you know, that image when the game was still in development. So yes, I know for a fact that is in fact Sam Lake. He's admitted it. It's him. So, okay. Here's the thing. Last words of Alan Wake, not even counting American Nightmare. Last words from Alan Wake are, it's not a lake, it's an ocean. What do we see? We see water. Okay. Then it ends with return. Now, anybody who's played the Alan Wake DLC knows that that was the last thing that Alan wrote on the typewriter on the last DLC mission. And Alan Wake Return has been trademarked recently. I'm just saying. I think That might have been a teaser. I think that might have been Alan Wake 2 teaser. I'm just saying. You can disagree with me if you want. In fact, I don't even know if I'm 100% behind this, but damn it, I want it to be true.
Paul had always been hungry for success. Driven. He made it onto a lot of those top young professionals lists. And now he was coordinating some huge project at the university. It's a big deal for him.
Hey, protest's over. Head home.
Not why I'm here, Chief. Holster that safety whistle.
Prick.
Where's your uniform?
Excuse me.
Come on. I've been in shit enough to smell at security.
You sure this is somewhere that you want to be sniffing around?
Was that supposed to be a threat? Because that's adorable.
Just walk away.
Liam Burke, a Monarch security officer. Our first meeting was cordial compared to him introducing a rifle butt to my head later on.
Okay, that was not a plot point, I don't think. Still looking for more plot points. I've discovered 43% of them. I have a 1% game completion. Maybe this, yeah, I can read this. The Dr. Kim Memorial. Oh, he died. Maybe I kind of already knew that. I'm sorry about that. I have read the book. In fact, I reviewed it recently.
Not exactly modest, are we, Paul?
Okay, I want to say something about the design of this building. I don't know if it has a real-world analog or something along those lines, the Meyer Physics Research Center, but I do know that there are buildings like it in universities and around universities all over the country, and I'm from the United States. A couple of comments that I want to make about this building in particular. It reminds me not of a building that was used for education, but Yale actually has a building, a sports rink, if you will, not too far from the campus. And it looks like a giant dinosaur. It's made of wood. This is metal. But it kind of very much has a, like, the arcing structure of this. I knew it was an Easter egg. I wasn't surprised that because I knew the Easter egg was there. But I didn't know the contents of the Easter egg. So that was better than I ever could have imagined. Okay, guys, for those of you watching it, you can't see my chat window. But I was just asked if I was surprised at the Easter egg. Yes and no. Yes. I was surprised at the contents. It was very exciting to watch, but know that I knew it was there. Like I was told to check it out by Remedy. So just, yeah, we'll move on. Plenty more to look at.
You made a long trip just to see a research project?
Well, reading between the lines, Paul was under a lot of pressure. He needed a friend. I wanted to help him any way I could.
Son of a bitch.
Jack Joyce. In the flesh.
The esteemed Mr. Paul Serene. I'm shaking money bags.
Shut up and bring it in.
Man hug.
Welcome home. 6 years. And I was starting to think you'd never come back.
Yeah, me too.
Come on.
This way. We're going upstairs to the project lab. How was the flight?
First class. Thank you for that. It's a step up from our van trip to Utah.
I missed that van.
I'm guessing Will's not meeting us.
He doesn't know we're here.
I knew Paul had asked my brother Will to consult on his project. Will was all the family I had, but he was difficult.
Let's see if there's anything else useful around here to take a look at before we go see him. Kind of want to mess around a little bit in here because it really does look kind of cool actually in here. I have seen,
You think you got enough space here?
Well, you know, us business types need somewhere to practice our putting.
What is
this?
Jesus, Will. You do this time.
Oh boy. Found something. Okay, a couple of comments. Like I said, this kind of reminds me of like a university library or something like that. A little bit more modern. Yeah, I was being told, I'm being told now, I looked very excited when I saw it. Yes, that's my inner Remedy fanboy. I have been a fanboy of Remedy. It's
far more exciting than the lobby.
That will be for me to decide.
Aw, I want a balls. Okay, I'm going to say this right now to all game developers. Put balls in vending machines in your games, damn it. Anywhere I can screw around over here, look at stuff? Let's see. I mean, Paul, I like you a lot, but I gotta go check out those narrative objects. Oh, I think there's something here. It's like a model.
It's quite the facility you got here.
What can I say? I have a knack of milking money out of wealthy investors.
That's cool. Performance is pretty good in here. Let's see what else we got.
Protests against Monarch are going strong, I see.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised you didn't join in. I thought that kind of trouble was your forte.
Well, it used to be our forte. You're the one that sold out.
Oh, I don't know. Rich and successful isn't too bad. You should give it a try.
Well, I think that's it for this particular area. Let's move on. Go into the I want to go on the elevator.
There's more to this than you're letting on. Is it about my brother?
Still worry about him, huh?
If Will did something wrong, then...
Jack, man. Look, I've been tight-lipped about this for a reason. This project we've been working on is going to change the entire world.
Why do I smell one of your long-winded presentations on the horizon?
I would never.
Oh, look. A perfectly placed presentation to illustrate the project. Now, who put that there?
Evil companies.
Okay. Enough joking. The lab's this way, Jack. Come on.
We'll get to your lab. I want
to
see your
I just got an achievement.
I know you love this stuff.
I just got an achievement. I don't know if you can see that, but I just got an achievement called Marketing Spiel.
Well,
25 points.
If you insist. Progress. Our primary drive as a species. Over time, we have cured life-threatening illnesses. Explore the world.
Oh, good. Going into marketing spiel mode.
Don't ruin my flow. But there is one element which denies us true progress. Time itself. Now, I'm not a scientist, but here's how it's being explained to me. We've known that, in theory, a rotating black hole creates a deformation in space-time, potentially allowing travel through both space and time. Years ago, William Joyce, your brother, posited the existence of chronon particles, now known as Meyer-Joyce particles, which fill an all-encompassing field, enabling the constant and steady progression of time. Here at Project Promenade, we have combined both these theories to discover a way to manipulate that field. And the results are staggering. There's more. But that's enough of a primer for now.
All right, let's do this. So this is about quantum physics. Paul, you know my brother spent years stuck down that rabbit hole. Is that why you brought Will on as a consultant?
When Dr. Kim passed away, your brother was the obvious choice to bring in to replace him.
Let's see if any of those work. So that was an achievement. That was cool. I don't see any more active stuff to check out just yet.
Over here, Jack. This is what I've been working on.
Yeah, hold your horses. Yeah, I did get the strategy guide. I picked it up this morning. This afternoon. That's another reason why I was late in starting the stream. I was late in starting the stream because I wanted to pick up the strategy guide. But I felt there's a reason. Okay, there's a twofold thing that I want to say about this strategy guide. Oh, 75% discovered. That's pretty cool. Couple of things first off. First off, this strategy guide, it might as well be an art book. It's got a lot of cool information on it. It's called the Secret History of Time Travel, includes History of Remedy, some development art, and that's a cool thing. And in today's day and age, you can, if you just simply want to find collectibles or get a walkthrough or something, it takes a 2-second Google search or a trip to www.gamefaqs.com. That's it. So a lot of the game book companies basically are getting with the times in that they realize that nobody wants to buy these things unless they also get some bang for their buck. And that if you simply make them like a coffee table-esque book where you provide art book, you know, it's visually nice, nice hardcover, nice quality, people will pick these up because they make for good coffee table books and, you know, people are going to want to see the art and stuff like that. In this case, this is usually you get one book and then you get like a hardcover version. And or maybe a third version or something along those lines when it comes to that sort of thing. Because it used to be that a game would get like a paperback guidebook, and if it was really, really lucky, you'd get an art book alongside it. And then it got to a point where they would include the art book bundled with the guidebook. They would be separate. You get a hard, you know, that's how they did it for Alan Wake. And then sometime around 2010, probably around the end of 2010, it was one of the publishers came up with the idea, why don't you just put one book? We'll still sell a paperback, but if you buy the hardcover, we'll give you like, you know, a couple, you know, extra pages of all kinds of cool extra stuff, like concept art or illustrations or downloads or something like that. And what eventually happened was is that today Remedy announced that they were only doing one production run of this book, and that was it. And this is the only guidebook that's going to be released for this game. And it's got all those tidbits, and according to this, it says it's going to have a free e-guide for smartphones and tablets. So there's a download code in here somewhere for like an e-guide or something. So there's that. I kind of wanted to buy it at Best Buy, but Best Buy isn't selling guidebooks anymore. I know, I was surprised too. So I had to go to GameStop to buy it. Okay, let's go check out Paul. I think I looked at everything over here. Okay. All right, a quick comment about this. His shirt. I really, really wish we could do DLC where you could change his shirt to match what he wore on the Gamescom demo. Oh, boy.
Welcome to Project Promenade.
Oh, boy.
Oh, shit. You guys must have some budget. What is all this?
The future, Jack. You are looking at the biggest discovery of our time.
It's impressive, but Will's the scientist. What do you need me for?
There's a reason we're doing this at 4 a.m., Jack. I need someone I can trust. I need you to help me convince Will.
Yeah, I had a hunch.
When your brother found out the scope of what we were building here, he... Well, you know Will.
Yeah.
We don't know... I'm being asked right now, is there going to be story DLC? As far as we know just right now, there has not been any announcement of future content. Even when Alan Wake came out, Remedy did say that they were planning on releasing downloadable content for the game. Since this game does not have a multiplayer component, that's highly unlikely that they're going to release any type of extra missions or something. I mean, Remedy's the kind of company that's like, heck, if we get another idea to do another story, we'll just make a sequel or a spinoff game. That's the kind of guys Remedy's are. They're not the kind of person that'll charge you $60 for a game and then piecemeal you out extra, you know, extra content that you should have gotten in the main game for an extra $20 to $40. They're not those kind of guys. And I remember distinctly that when Alan Wake came out and they released the DLC, it was actually pretty damn cheap. And they gave the first DLC away to anybody that legitimately bought the game at retail new. So that's just the kind of guys that Remedy is. But I don't know. Maybe there might be extra DLC missions. I can say this, though. There is a DLC pack, which I have downloaded right now. It includes the episodes. It includes the live action video components. We will not be streaming the live action video components. Those are already stored on my external hard drive, so we're already good there. However, caveat, I haven't tested them yet. None of this has been tested, so I can't guarantee you performance on this, and I've heard things about performance here. I've also heard some other stuff, but we'll talk about that later. Oh, if you want extra content, sorry, one last thing. If you want extra content or extra story tidbits and stuff like that that you're not getting here, read the book. There is a book. I've reviewed the book. It has a lot more information than what I've been seeing here so far. So if you want more or further fleshed out story, read the book. Cam Rogers did a book. It's out. It's on Kindle now. It's at paperback and hardcover. I read the paperback. It's good.
Hang on, I gotta get something from my desk. Will overreacted, scared off the investors, ranting about miscalculations, dangers, all with no evidence. It works, but they're gonna cut our funding if I don't prove it. I see the concept of personal space is still foreign to you.
Hey, somebody's gotta keep tabs on you.
Oh, that's cool. Hey, I need those narrative objects. I want that damn. I want to get a damn achievement for it.
Jack, you know asking for our help is not easy for me. I am in deep trouble. You see, the tests I have to run here are not strictly speaking legal. You're the only one I can trust to help me with this.
Whatever Will did, I want to make it right.
I love my older brother, but he didn't make it easy.
It's already essentially set up. Anyone can do it, but you're the one I want to do this with. Jack, thank you. I knew I could count on you.
That's what this is all about. That's why Jack is here. Jack is here because Paul needed him. He needed someone to do this test. And here it is, right here. This is the flavor test right here. And some of this was mentioned in the book. Like the actual scenes and stuff like that. They were referenced. So. Oh, the Ram statue we just saw. Yeah. Yeah, actually they had to scan that. Apparently the Ram statue was a real thing. This is still going on. Where's the fighting in this game? All right. Keep your shirt on. This is it. I think this is the last.
So, what's this?
Corridor schematics. Travel clockwise leads to a forward progression in time. Counterclockwise, travel backwards.
Oh, it's like you invented a clock.
Yes. Years ahead of our time. I need you to push the lever over there, labeled chronon conduit. That'll activate the core. I'm going to run diagnostics and make sure it remains stable.
Okay, anybody having Half-Life, basically this opening, David, you're asking where's the fighting in this game. This game, it looks like it's starting up like Half-Life did, and actually Half-Life did something similar to this back in 1998. Half-Life 2 also did something like this. You gotta be able to set the scene. You gotta know why you're fighting. You gotta know why you're doing what you're doing. Alan Wake did this. Max Payne really did not, I'll be honest. But, okay, this technology here... Oh, I gotta hold it, I see.
That's just the chronon conduit initiating.
Okay. I'm gonna say... I basically say this.
Are you sure it's supposed to do that?
Figures.
Wow.
What was that?
The core replicates the effects of a rotating micro black hole, so activating it can be a bit... intense.
A black hole. What exactly are we testing here?
You're about to find out. This way. We've got to raise the corridor. Just like old times, eh? Slightly illegal, moderately reckless.
I'd raised some hell with Paul in the past. I could tell this was different. Still, I didn't understand how massive and far-reaching the consequences for this would be. How could I?
I knew Paul. He played it cool, but I could tell he was nervous.
What's happening? We're really doing this, Jack. It's gonna be amazing.
Okay. For those of you curious, it's like, well, why is a major organization funding a supermassive black hole program?
You need this key to activate the corridor.
All right. Oh, okay. Sorry, I'm trying to grab it. I just gotta get pixel perfect on it.
We need to turn the keys at the same time to activate. Security precautions. Ready?
It's like we're launching a nuke.
Yeah, basically.
Wait, we're not launching a nuke, right?
One way to find out. 3, 2, 1.
Two men.
God damn, Paul. What is this?
The corridor. The passenger enters one end, travels around the loop, exits the other, and arrives at the predetermined time in the physical location where the machine is situated in that time.
Passenger? Wait. This is a corridor for... You're actually going inside that thing? In the machine, through time? It's a fucking time machine.
I'm going to be the first, Jack. And you're my witness.
This is crazy, Paul. And this can't be safe. What happens when...
Our team has already proved it works in the trial phase. It is ready. We've passed every test, every inspection. We're about to make history, Jack. All you have to do is hit that switch.
Okay, this is played out a little bit differently than it was in the book.
2 minutes to the past.
Remember this moment.
Yeah, this is playing out differently than it did in the book.
Paul, what? How?
It's fine. It's okay. Stay calm, Jack.
Stay calm. There's two of you. You just fucking multiplied.
This is exactly what was supposed to happen. He's me, a future version of me from 2 minutes in the future. Your evil future self. We did it. Fucking incredible. I mean, just imagine the implications. We could warn people about disasters before they happen. Cure diseases before they spread. I just had this conversation. Still sounds good second time.
Jesus Christ.
Now go into the machine. You need to complete the cycle. Yeah. Yes. Of course.
Wait, Paul, what are you doing?
Okay, this scene does play out differently in the book. In the book, Jack goes in.
I need to enter the machine and travel back to the moment I exited the machine in order to, well, be here.
And what if you don't?
Boom. There is no what if. I'm here. It's already happened. You saw it, Jack. We did it.
Oh, that's impossible. That's literally impossible. I mean, I can't even...
There's no time to stop now. We need to test the other direction. Set the machine to 5 minutes to the future.
Oh, boy. Okay, like I said, in the loop is just closed. Now, this is the theory about this particular thing. This prevents the grandfather paradox, basically. What if you go back in time and kill your grandfather? Will you currently exist? From what I heard from most people, they all say the same thing. No, because you create a new universe every time you travel, either backwards or forwards in time.
Soak this in, Jack. What we're doing right here, right now, people are going to write about this for centuries to come.
All right, let's push the button. Now remember, he was sent... Oh boy.
What are you doing? You have to help me with this. We have to shut this thing down now.
No, 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 no. Stop him.
Shut up.
Hold on. The core.
Hold on. We can't shut it down. Paul's still in there.
Will.
Shut up. Look at me. Look at me. Put the gun down and we can talk, okay?
No, there's no time.
You're not thinking straight. Put the gun down.
Jesus Christ, Will.
Time is going to end. Jack, you have to trust me.
Or what? No, I gotta let you out.
Oh boy. That's bad. That's really bad.
You okay?
I think so. I'll find a way out. Make sure Will's okay.
Yeah. Okay.
I could hear Will's words in my head. Time is going to end.
Okay, I just got an achievement. You were there when time broke. Oh boy. Physics is going crazy right now.
What the fuck is this?
It
broke.
It should have worked.
Time.
Alright. Okay. Said go check on Will.
Is this really happening?
Okay, now I want you to look at this right here, because this was an important plot point in the book as well. It says destination error. It looks like Jack Bauer for 24. Well, actually, which one? Does Jack or does Will? Or who looks like Jack Bauer? Which actor or character?
What the hell?
I think that's Will right there.
This is crazy.
Sorry, just checking my... Let's see if we can grab Will.
Will.
Actually, that's Sean Ashmore. I remember him from Animorphs and X-Men. We have our title.
She warned me. I knew she was right. All this time. I warned Paul. This could all have been avoided. We're too late.
Alright, let's see if we can help Paul out. Paul looks okay in there. Uh-oh.
Stunner. Collapsed.
That's bad.
There's no other way out. I'm going through the machine.
Paul, wait.
No! Jack! This way! Jack!
All right, let's go.
I didn't want to leave Paul, but there was no way to help him. I didn't know where he'd end up.
Hurry.
This is a giant cyclotron.
What the hell?
Hurry, this way.
I recognize this piping. This is the kind of piping that they'd have at a Large Hadron Collider. Yeah, there's some frame rate drops on my end too. And now Pat, what? David has just informed me that now Patty Duke has died. Grim Reaper, where are you? Oh boy. Loading screen.
Jack,
Your hands. Gotta keep moving.
No! Neo, have I told you about the Matrix? We don't have to talk about the Matrix if you don't want to, Neo. We could talk about other stuff, like, stuff. Girls Who Broke Our Hearts, the Matrix.
Jack. You just... What just... Go. This way. Move.
That was the first time my power started to manifest. An out-of-control burst of energy that saved Will.
Jack, your proximity to the pulse, it... It must have altered your relation to the Chronos.
Will, what I just did back there, what the hell is happening?
That's what I'm telling you.
Not in the right language.
Cover me. I'll try to explain. We have to go.
Yeah, I can't go that way. I'll have to go this way. Alright, let's check out this way. I finally have a weapon.
Explosion make time go bad. If time is an egg, then that egg is fucking broken. The time egg is fucked.
What?
Ladies and gentlemen, Sam Lake's dialogue, everyone.
There's a fracture in time. It's breaking down, leading to the end of time and door.
What?
Locked. They cut my security clearance. That didn't help.
Yeah, my external drive might be the reason the frame rate drop is dropping. I can't really think of a solution other than simply just removing a game on my system, moving the installation files for this to the primary drive and seeing if that affects anything. But I can't do that right now. I'll probably take a look at it later. Let's take a pause here. Just a quick pause. I'm going to take a quick pause here. We're just going to take a break. I'm not going to stop the stream. I just got to take a quick break, and I'll be back in just a minute, okay?